Remember when everyone thought the world was going to end in 2012 and then it didn't? People were terrified. Books were written. A movie depicting what would happen was released in 2009. It was thought tsunamis would floor the Earth, grounds would split, asteroids would fall. But instead, all that happened were memes. A new iPhone and Adele won a bunch of Grammys. And remember that Y2K thing when everyone thought computers would explode and turn into robots or something? Well, the same fear was placed on the Mayan civilization when the calendar ended on the year 2012. So why didn't the world explode? Clues explaining why have been recently unveiled. But it's not just that. For years, people wondered how the Egyptians built the pyramids. They thought there was no way that people could have made these incredible structures without advanced technology developed hundreds of years later. But recently, research teams found ramp-like structures that suggested they used a pulley system to lift and move the stones. We can't know for sure, but these discoveries are a bit more sound than what people thought before. Aliens. If you're a believer, give us a like and subscribe. There are plenty more mysteries where that came from, like the Lost Colony. After settler John White left his colony and family behind in North Carolina to the UK, he returned to find the entire colony had disappeared. People have thought of theories of what could have happened, and again, they think aliens wiped them out, or they were overtaken by a Native American tribe. However, White found one clue etched onto a tree, the word Croatoan. White didn't know what this meant and never found his family or the colony for the rest of his life. Theories include one where the colony tried to sail back to the UK by sea and died on the way. But the most prominent involves a Native American tribe now known as the Lumbee. Similar traditions suggest that settlers were taken and intermarried with a tribe called Croatoan, and the Croatoan tribe evolved to be the Lumbee tribe, while others were named Cherokee. But no one knows for sure, not even those DNA kits everybody seems to be doing today. We've talked a bit about aliens, so I guess it's time we bring up the crop circles. I guess that's what you would call the Nazca lines. In the Nazca Desert in Peru, engraved lines from images can be seen by a plane. They were created in 500 BC, but only discovered in 1930. Why? Well, it coincides with the invention of an airplane, of course, but wait. The Nazca people didn't have planes in 500 BC, so how did these lines depicting animals and plants occur? One theorist, Jim Woodman, suggests that they used hot air balloons and even tried himself using the tools the Nazcans would have had. And it worked, but scientists say there's not enough evidence. That's not the only mystery, though. The Nazca people survived in a desert for 1,000 years. Besides aliens, researchers and archaeologists have developed a theory that these lines were all part of an irrigation network. Oh, so through a hydraulic system, they were able to travel over water. And turns out, through trial and error, it was proven these lines could easily be made with carbon stakes and simple tools. So, back to the Mayans. If the Earth didn't end in 2012, then what did the date on their calendar signify? They prophesized suffering and the destruction of all things. Researchers stated the Mayans were actually just drama queens when it came to their writing. What they meant could have simply been the end of one age and the beginning of the next. A discovery in May 2012 also showed a sun and moon chart that surpassed the year 2012. So really, the Mayans never actually warned of the end of the world at all. A lot of these stories are people thinking they understand something and letting their minds wander like crazy, but evidence shows that there's always a reasonable explanation. Unless, you know, it actually is aliens.